Left, right, and mid are useful when, for example, in the previous example, there's exactly the same number of characters in each item. But over here, you can see we've got the situation where on the first line, the name of the product is a bit longer than the second line. So we want to create formulas that will also extract this. The key here is to understand that we need to know how this column needs to be delimited, so we can see it's because of the hashes. And then we need to tell Excel where these hashes are. So a useful function in Excel to do that is either the find or the search function. As shown here, find is case sensitive. Search is not case sensitive. So if you need to find a capital A, and that's different from a small a, you'll use find. If you want to find A, whether it's capital or not, you would use search. We're going to just use the find, but the mechanics are the same. So I'm going to go and find the find function. And you'll see it says find text. So now what it's asking for is, what is it looking for? We can see it's a hash. So in inverted commas, I'm going to put a hash. Where must it go look for that hash? I'm going to say, please go look over here. And you'll see immediately it tells me it's found one at character 14. And you've got something called start number, which we'll look at just now. For now, we'll leave it blank. So when I say OK, you'll see it's pulled out where the hash is, where the first hash is. So now what we can do, I can go back and use my left function. So let's go, we're going to say left. Where's the text? That's easy. How many characters do I want? Well, I know that when I'm in here, I want it to go just before the 14. When I'm in here, it must go just before the 20. So the number of characters then is going to be whatever's in that cell. Notice that if I leave it like that, what it's going to do is give me the product name, but it includes the hash. So depending on what you want, I might go and put a minus one here so that it excludes the hash. I can say OK, and I can copy it down. We now need to separate the other two areas, the middle section here and the right section. So what we need to do is figure out where the second hash is. So I'm going to come, again I'm going to use the find function. So again it's saying find text, I'm going to say please find a hash. Where must it find it? Over here. And notice that because it doesn't know what you've done previously, it says, oh, I found a hash at 14. Which is the same one here. And that's why you've got this thing called start number, because what you're going to tell Excel is, please don't start at number one, start somewhere else. And in this case, I could type it in, but I want to link it. So I'm going to say start at whatever is in that cell there. Notice it's still saying 14 because it starts, immediately finds it and tells us where it is. So we have to go over here and say plus one. So please start at whatever's in here plus one. And then it tells you that the hash is now at character number 26. So I'm going to come and copy that down. So now we know where the first hash is and where the second hash is. So what we're going to use to extract the middle here is the mid function. So where's the text? We're going to say it's over here. Where must it start? Well, I know I want to pull it out. There's the hash. I'm going to start just one to the hash. How do I know where that hash is? Well, I've pulled out a character here, so I'm going to say start over there. Because I don't want it to start on the hash, but one away from the hash, I'm going to say plus one. How many characters do I want to pull out? Well, I know it must be between that hash and that hash. It's just those characters. But as you can see, these change size. I know where the first and the second hash is, so what I can do is I can say take where the second hash is, subtract where the first hash is, and it'll give us an extract. Notice when I do this, I still seem to have the hash over here, so in this case I might have to go and minus one. When I say OK, I can copy that down, and you'll see it pulls out the column exactly. The third one is a very simple one because it's always on the right-hand side. It always seems to be three characters. So we're going to say right, point here, three characters, and say OK. So what I can now create is a template where I can copy and paste data in that has different size columns, and the template itself will figure out where the delimiters are and extract them all in one go.